Good evening, friends. Today is 17th of January 2018, and we are going to discuss important articles of Indian Express. First article is related to orange colored passports. This article would be covered in Indian diaspora topic of GS paper 2. First of all, what is context? Recently, Foreign Ministry declared that orange colored passports would be given to those persons who need immigration clearance before going to certain other countries for pursuing the job. So first question arises here. What kind of categories persons need the immigration clearance? Those persons who are illiterate, not educated, they are not 10th passed, they need the immigration clearance before going to certain other countries. Why? Because Foreign Ministry wants to protect them. Sometimes they are being exploited on the name of job. Some agents trap them and send them to other countries, and in those countries they are being exploited. So that's why this category of persons need immigration clearance, so that Foreign Ministry officials can make them aware about the laws of the country to which they are departing. Now, Foreign Ministry had decided that they would give orange colored passports to this category of persons so that they can easily be identified and easily be protected. Now, the article criticizes Foreign Ministry's this decision on many grounds. First point is, although the intentions of Foreign Ministry are good only, but approach is bad. If they really wanted to protect the vulnerable sections, they must have devised some other ways to protect them, because this decision may promote discrimination against that category of people who have given the orange colored passports. Look at simple case. There are two persons. One person is carrying navy blue colored passport and the other person is carrying orange colored passport. So first idea may come in mind that the person who is carrying the orange colored passport, that person is not educated, that person is not literate. So this decision may promote this kind of tendencies. Those persons who have been given orange colored passports, they would be discriminated. Second point is, it also hurts their dignity. It is against the article number 21, right to life with dignity. Apart from this, it is also violation of right to equality against article number 14 and article number 15. In article number 14 and 15, it has been explicitly written that no person can be discriminated on the basis of caste, sex, language. How government can discriminate any person on the basis of education? If any person is educated, then you are giving the navy blue color passport. But if any person is not educated, illiterate, then you are giving orange color passports. So it is against right to equality. It is against article 14 and 15. Next point is even more exploitation. After this decision, this category of people who have been given orange colored passports, they would be more vulnerable to exploitation. How? Because agents or criminals who exploit them on the basis on the name of job, they would be easily able to identify, oh, that person is carrying orange colored passport. They would assume that guy is not educated, that guy is illiterate, we can easily trap them. So they would be more vulnerable to exploitation. In the conclusion, it is said that this category of people who go to other countries for pursuing their job there, India gets a lot of remittances from this category of people. India as a country is benefited, their families are also benefited. So government must devise some other ways to protect this category of people. This decision of Foreign Ministry to give the orange colored passports to this category of people is against the constitutional values. Central government can learn something from Kerala's government in this respect. In Kerala, a separate department has been established for welfare of Indian diaspora. Because sometimes it also happens that Indian diaspora faces a lot of hardships in foreign countries. Due to the policies of foreign countries, they lose their job there and come back to India, only to find that there is no jobs in India. So that's why government needs to do something more for the welfare of Indian diaspora. So this was the article about the Foreign Ministry's decision of giving orange colored passports to that category of person who need immigration clearance. Let's move to next article. Next article is related to open access in electricity. And this article would be covered in infrastructure power topic of GS paper 3. What is context? Recently, Power Ministry released a consultation paper regarding open access in electricity. If government is implementing this decision, then there would be a lot of advantages of this decision. Number one is competitive market. There would be high competition between electricity companies to sell electricity to the consumers. Now look at case of internet service providers. Currently, there are a lot of internet service providers in markets. So there is competition between them, and their monthly plans or yearly plans are very cheap. So this kind of competition would also prevail between electricity companies if government is implementing open access in electricity market. Second advantage would be increase in choice. Consumers would be independent to choose their electricity company. Now what happens in case of internet service providers? Consumers are allowed to choose their internet service providers. So on the basis of plan and on the basis of service provided by different internet service providers, we choose our internet service provider. This would happen also in case of electricity companies. So customers' scope of choice would be enhanced. And apart from this, accountability of electricity companies would also be fixed, because they know if they are not providing good service, then customers would change electricity company. So this is second point. And third point is consistent power supply. Customers can take two electricity connections from two different companies. By doing so, customers can ensure consistent power supply. For example, if power is not coming from one DISCOM, then other DISCOM would definitely be providing power at that time. So power would be consistent. But there are some challenges also to implement this decision. First is transmission capacity. DISCOMs might not be having sufficient transmission capacity to supply the electricity to the consumers, and also usually they suffer from losses, so they may not have sufficient funds to establish requisite infrastructure also. So this is first challenge. And second challenge is, if customers would commence changing the electricity companies on regular basis or frequently, it may create problems for DISCOMs, because DISCOMs sign their agreements with electricity generators to procure electricity on long-term basis. So if customers change their moods very frequently, then situation may arise for DISCOMs. Sometimes it may happen that customers are demanding more and more electricity, but DISCOMs do not have sufficient electricity to supply to consumers. And sometimes DISCOMs may have surplus electricity, but consumers are not willing to purchase the electricity. In the conclusion, it is said that this idea is worth considering. Yes, challenges are there, but government can help DISCOM companies to tackle these challenges. Like, first challenge is, DISCOM companies might not be having sufficient transmission capacity, sufficient infrastructure to deliver power to the consumers. Government can help DISCOM companies to have sufficient transmission capacity. Government can help DISCOM companies to have sufficient infrastructure to deliver power to the consumers. And second challenge is, government can have some kind of threshold, like customers can change their electricity connection after 3 months only. In this case, procurement agreement, DISCOM companies would also be able to take care of their procurement agreements from electricity generators. So this was article about open access in electricity. Today we discussed two articles. First article was regarding Foreign Ministry's decision, in which Foreign Ministry decided to give orange color passports to ECR category people, those people who need immigration clearance before going to other countries, certain other countries, for pursuing their job there. And second article was related to open access in electricity. Both articles were important. So this is the end of our discussion. Thank you very much for discussion.